Good morning, everybody, and happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. And just a quick reminder that I am taking off here shortly after this video, so I'm going to try to make this as quick as possible. I really appreciate you guys taking out your time on this special Sunday to listen to this video. As a reminder, in the room itself, I've uploaded most of the charts here that are pertinent to this week, in my opinion. Let's go ahead and get started really quick. As always, we'll start here with the earnings chart. And you can see what's coming up. There's several names still. We are in the midst of earnings season, and some of my favorite names coming into this week are going to be John Deere on Friday, over here, Alibaba on Thursday, Walmart, Ross. I'm sorry, my wife likes a really great deal. It's Mother's Day. She loves going to Ross to find $5 shirts. So I'm interested in Ross itself. Coming over here on Wednesday, you can see we have Cisco, we have Target. I think this is TJ Maxx, and if it is, this is in the same category as Ross for me. Moving on over into Tuesday, Home Depot, one of my favorite stocks, who this year is on a yearly inside and down, and I've been going over that for several months. The yearly is projected to continue down, so I'm obviously interested in their fundamentals and see how they do. Another China name here at Baidu coming in on Tuesday morning as well. And as we move down, I don't see a whole lot right here that really jumps out at me. Monday morning, tomorrow, anything that is interesting to you, we'll see here. Here's a name I remember from the past. Who remembers those days when the small caps were actually running and now all of them are pretty much penny stocks? So this is probably like a bad reminder to some traders out there, but there is workhorse on Monday. And then moving down, I'm not seeing a whole lot on Monday that really, grabs my attention. All right, so moving over into our watch, so market watch, what basically this is any kind of information that could cause some volatility in the market. Remember here with trendy methodology, we say this, and I would write this down in your journal. News is a catalyst that pushes price into our levels, supply and demand, trendy edges, the cloud, and so forth. So we like news. We personally don't let news influence our trading, if you will. Okay. So Monday, what I'm seeing right away is there's a lot of Fed speakers coming up. So Monday, we have Fed President Goolsbee, 9:15. So basically 8:30, this is Eastern, okay? So this is going to be before the market opens. And then 9:15, once again, right before the market opens, we have a Fed president speaking. Tuesday, another Fed. 8:30, followed by retail sales. I do think we could see a little bit of spike in the market there as well, up or down, I should say. And moving on down here, Home Builder Confidence Index is important to me. Fed Vice Chair Barr, 10:30. Richmond Fed President Barkin, 12:15. Williams, 2:30. Looking at Goolsbee again. This Goolsbee man, they're talking a lot, aren't they? And then 7 o'clock at night, we have Bostic and Chicago Fed President Goolsbee again. Our next, information here coming in on Wednesday, it's housing starts, building permits. And then on Thursday, we are looking at initial jobless claims. Very important. 9:15, Phillips, 9:13. You have Barr moving on down here at 10, existing home sales. 10 o'clock, economic indicators. Friday, interesting. We have Fed President again at 11 o'clock. Powell and former Fed Chairman Bernanke on panel. Moving on over, I'm going to make these quick. This is your neutral strategy from last week. You can see, guys, that the levels worked really well. Again, we didn't close over the green level. We didn't really get that move or that trigger to the upside. Matter of fact, things just kind of came down and back down into neutral. And then we finally broke down and closed below, giving you targets T1 and T2 to the tick. Overall, though, just a sideways market on the SPY. QQQ, we did get the breakout above the green. We got the trigger long. You did get Target one, couldn't quite make it. And just to point out what I think is very important here is that, you know, looking over at SPY kind of gives you the clue that, you know, the market was kind of finished. Okay. So again, we did, you know, push a little bit above here, but again, just ended the week in the neutral, and look how the bottom part of the neutral there also worked very well. So overall, just a very neutral week. Going into this week, these are your new numbers. Just please take a screenshot really quick. And again, as a reminder, these are uploaded in the file, in your room file. So please click on that. That's your little icon in the upper right-hand corner that looks like a file or a folder, I should say. Click on that. Go to images, and you're going to see all these charts in there. And again, if you don't know how to trade the neutral strategy, just go to my YouTube channel. We have a very quick video on how I trade this. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. Going on, this is the SPY on the bigger picture. So instead of using the quarterly this week, I went ahead and went with the monthly because I think that it's painting us a very nice picture here that you can see. First of all, we have 17 days and 7 hours before this monthly actually closes. So what I'm talking about now can and will drastically change. I say will drastically change. I really hope it does, because I don't know about you, but this chop is really, really frustrating at the moment. But there are ways to trade it, obviously, and we teach that every single morning. So SPY bigger picture here. Again, I spelt that wrong. For bulls, it does not get interesting until we get over 416. And so far, the support of the monthly cloud is right here, and you can see that as well. So be paying attention to the monthly is what I'm trying to tell you. If you have a frustrating time, if you don't have a process for the morning to take advantage of the market, please come hang out with us. If you have a process, then just add this to your tools. Pay attention to the monthly, okay? Because right now it's telling me we have an inside week month, and I wouldn't expect a whole lot. We're supported very closely here, and we're also rejected here. It just feels like an inside month, as I said, for at least 17 days or so. Okay. All right. So the next one I'm going to show you are the Qs. Once again, this is a monthly. The biggest thing that I want to point out is we went from red to white. So your momentum is changing. We're rounding out down here on the TTM squeeze. We have higher yellow histogram bars. Things look pretty good here. So I'm definitely interested in the Qs and in tech just to see how this shapes out. The market is telling me that we could be coming into an area where we just basically could see a really big move. I'm hoping that's going to happen soon. Either direction, I'm not biased right now. But far as the Qs are concerned, we're held up by support just like the SPY. We have a little bit of resistance above. I would be, if we continue to push up, I'd be looking at this wick here as a reference point where we could see a rejection, okay? So red to white on the candles, momentum is changing. Support is the cloud for right now, and the 38.2. You can see there's some beautiful confluence there with the EMA cloud and the Fibonacci's. Bulls, let's see, you want 334. I know you do. It's a little bit of distance away. And bears, you need below 317 to really, like, you know, something, in my opinion, to start happening. And really, even under 317, it's tradable. But the big picture, again, I think is very important. 309 being your support, 346 being the target to the upside. Let's go ahead and move on into the dollar. Dollar is important. Notice that the inside and up formation we found months ago, it's still holding. It can't break below that support. You can see we've come back and tested it several times here on the monthly. And now we're starting to try to push up. So bulls, what that means for you is the market could be looking at pulling back a little bit. And the question is, how long can it pull back? Well, until it gets to demand. But we can also reference the dollar, because the idea is that the dollar can continue to move up until it hits resistance. Your resistance on the dollar is 103.887. And then the next level here is 105.77. And what I'm saying is, bulls, be cautious, especially if the dollar starts to bid above $1.04. Okay. Bears, you need $1.04. All right. Moving on in here, we have the TNX. Again, my projection was for the TNX to come down here into demand on a smaller time frame. It hasn't quite got there, but it's also rejecting right here at resistance. And because of that, it looks like the TNX is just kind of sideways. Over here, let's get into futures. So for my future traders, you know, we have an amazing process that we go over every single morning. If you guys also trade futures, definitely the methodology that I'm teaching is the place for you. Okay. We have a really good methodology that we trade, that we coach every single morning. And even if you don't trade it, you can use these blueprints to trade the SPY or SPX when we're talking about ES futures. The weekly, we've had these levels on here for a very long time. You can see the supply level is working. We have our automated levels as well. These are called trendy edges. They find playing fields of supply and demand. Notice that price is pushed up into supply. Again, we found these a long time ago. Our bigger support continues to hold. So this weekly chart is not changing going into this week. Let's go ahead and move into the daily. I did change my triggers. Please take note of those. Again, you can screenshot them or throw them on your chart. Biggest thing here, folks, is when the price gets into the levels that I have placed here, what we do is we go over to the TTM squeeze. We change the time frame. So even though the level is, say, on a daily or a weekly, we go to a time frame of 5 to 1 minute, and then I teach from there. You guys know the process if you're here in the room, and if not, come and check us out. I'll teach you. All right, so these are our resistant, our short trigger, our long triggers, and you can see where those are. Notice that we do have a little bit of demand down here. In a perfect world, a reset would be really nice down at 40.29. And bulls, you have to get above the supply zone before it even gets interesting, okay? All right, let's go ahead and move on to the next one. This is going to be your 4 hour chart. I went ahead and changed this around for you as well. Go ahead and show you demand levels here. We have a support level here. We have cloud resistance until it's not. So basically what I'm trying to say, bulls, once you get over this, it's not that easy though. All right. So we have now built two supply zones above current price with the inside and down formation. This is a strong candle down. So you're really going to have to show off and get above these pivots here in order for things to get interesting. But then again, just like here, you have a little bit of distance you can travel, and then you run right into this resistance, right? And even if we get over this supply, if you get over that, you're jumping right into resistance. It just looks really choppy. And that's why for me, I keep my mind open that, hey, a reset is not a bad thing. You're just giving me the opportunity to go shopping at a clearance rack. Let's go ahead and move over here to the NASDAQ futures. Once again, this is going to look a little bit different, but I want to note down here that your histogram bar on your TTM Squeeze Pro is now dark blue. What it's telling you is the buying pressure is kind of easing off, and we could see that by looking at the topping wick here. And it also hit the and close to the trendy edge, which is your automated level there as well, identifying the supply zone that I have a red box around. Notice that the support is 12,867 by 413. Once again, this is also confluent with the cloud bears. You have some distance where we can make some money to the downside. Bulls, you're going to have to prove that you can hold above 13,248. Next level here is going to be your daily triggers. These have also changed. Please take note, you can take a screenshot. Same thing. Once we get there, we like to use the TTM Squeeze Pro and use it anywhere from a 5 to 1 minute. Let's go ahead and move over here into our next chart, which would be the NASDAQ 4 hour. And again, I've identified supply, support, demand. Really quick, I get the question here and there. Hey, John, which one is the most important to pay attention? Folks, this is why I teach you how to, use your time frames on your thinkorswim. I have a video on YouTube as well, super quick and easy, how to set that up, and I'll show you that here in a second. But do that because I'm constantly going through the time frames. These are my favorite time frames. Each level is important, and every time we hit one of these levels, I apply the methodology or the teaching behind the TTM Squeeze Pro and how we trade those. All right, so all of them are important. It's just important to understand where you are on several different time frames. Okay. All right. So over here, right-hand side. So the skew is really important. I find it super convenient to use with my methodology. Basically my sentiment for this week, Guys, we've come into basically resistance and or supply for several weeks now. It's the same supply zones, it's the same resistance levels, it's the same support levels. Everything is completely choppy, but I'm noticing that the skew continues to rise. It is an area where I would say protection risk off. What I mean by that is not that we can't go long. It just means if you're going long, I would not expect a whole lot from that. It's base hits until it's a home run. We're not in this game to, you know, step up and try to hit a home run every time. We're here to for base hits. That's what wins the game. And I want to make sure that you guys are aware that we have hit supply. We have rejected. The skew is rising, the dollar is bouncing, the TNX is bouncing. All signs say caution. But again, we are in earnings season, so there's a lot of names out there, onesies and twosies, that can still run. And really, that's our main job going into earnings season, is try to decipher and pick through some of the sludge, if you will, and look for the names that are trending. Thankfully, we have a great system. We're looking for great names. Guys, if you didn't get a chance to watch last week's review, it's just really quickly going over all of our alerts that come straight from my API. As soon as I click trade, right, and I get into a long or a short, you are aware of that within milliseconds, which is really cool, so that you can see the proof of concept. We had a lot of wins last week, but it wasn't easy. So if you didn't do well on your allocation, you could have still lost money. Again, win percentages are great, but once you get there, there's a lot more to learn. Okay, market hasn't been easy. Keep your chin up. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. I hope this review helped you. Please take the time to just like and comment. I really appreciate you. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow morning. And again, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there.